How our state responds to natural disasters will be overhauled following a report into the Lismore floods. The state government will adopt all 28 recommendations, while SES volunteers have hit out, claiming they have been unfairly blamed.
With their orange overalls soaked through, the work by Lismore's SES was exhausting and thankless.
We're here to help. We don't get a cent, so it's all volunteer work.
But while the government's flood report concludes that the SES leadership failed in Lismore, the volunteers feel they've been disrespected.
Their own houses were being flooded as they were performing these flood rescues.
Nine News has learned there are 28 recommendations in the 700-page report, which was compiled by former Police Commissioner Mick Fuller and Chief Scientist Mary O'Kane. All of the recommendations have been supported either in principle or in full.
The recommendations that we will announce shortly and the changes that we will make enhance our frontline.
The State Emergency Service will partially merge with the Rural Fire Service. Flood emergencies will be coordinated out of RFS HQ at Olympic Park, not Wollongong. And crucial SES administration and planning services will be taken over by the firefighters. Plus, a single app will be established to coordinate disasters rather than each agency having its own. But it's funding, especially for the SES, that needs addressing.
I think this is a wake-up call for everybody. Just because there's no floods, just because there's no bushfires, doesn't mean you can't put money into these frontline emergency services.
The tinny army that was pulling thousands of people from their roofs in Lismore will be formalised. It will be a community-first responders program, offering training to locals on how to conduct flood rescues with their private boats. Plus, a flood rescue training centre will be built to properly practice flood rescues.
It would be completely wrong to form a view that there's fault on the SES in relation to this review.
Shane Fitzsimmons will lose his job as the Commissioner of Resilience New South Wales. The agency will be dismantled and Mr. Fitzsimmons will cease being the chairman of the State Emergency Management Committee.
A fifth deputy police commissioner will be appointed to be in charge of disaster response and recovery. But Nine News has learned that Mick Fuller did not meet with his successor, Commissioner Karen Webb, to ask her what she thought of the changes.
The report will be formally released in Lismore tomorrow. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.